Greetings, leaders. Pardon the rough voice. We're in the middle of COVID week at the Duncan house. So I'll keep this brief and try not to cough in your ear. Anyway, I'm Dr. Brent Duncan. I'm excited about the opportunity to be your guide on your quest to apply IO psychology concepts and tools to build high-performance organizations. As we start exploring how to apply psychology to drive performance in the workplace and build high-performance workplaces, I hope we're all motivated to connect course concepts, tools, and practices for our own success in school, work, and life. You can read my bio in the classroom, so I'm not going to bore you with it here. I'd just like to spend a few minutes promoting the live sessions I will hold each week and touching on some tips I'll discuss further during the week one live session. So to help us all get a good start in this course, I hope you'll join your classmates and me each week for a live session in the Blackboard Collaborate classroom. We'll network with classmates, review essential course concepts, resources, and activities. We'll demonstrate tools for automating arduous tasks so we can focus efforts on learning and performance, and we'll carefully review each week's assignments and activities. You'll see a general announcement in the classroom and an appointment in the course calendar. I'll also post reminders each week. So for the first live session, we'll take a look at the big picture. Then we'll show you how to break it down into activities, interconnected chunks, then start planning for individual and group success. We will also review your course activities and assignments. For week one, I'll also plan to cover some critical tips for building a strong success foundation for the course. These include master planning skills. In short, we'll discuss how to start each week breaking course activities and assignments into tasks, then schedule time every day to make progress on our weekly project lists. Next, we'll talk about developing strategic study practices. This means start with the end game. Know the big picture before diving into the resources. Do not read word for word and highlight. You want to outline your DQs and assignments first, then scan the resources to find the information you need to complete your activities. Then you mark the relevant information, write it down, discuss it with others, apply it to your DQs and assignments. Next, important to me, stop balancing, stop juggling. Start integrating and synthesizing. In short, do not isolate yourselves from work, family, and community by attempting to balance and juggle different aspects of life as separate compartments. Create opportunities to engage family, friends, coworkers, and bosses in your school activities. You leverage assignments to develop projects for work and strengthen your community. You engage your family and friends as study partners, sounding boards, research partners. While you might need to find a balance between work and life, you can elevate both work and life by higher education through integration and synthesis. Well, that's all for me for now. Excuse me. I'm looking forward to hearing your ideas and practices for leveraging our study of organizational psychology to enhance our lives and careers. Please send me a private message with your questions, comments, and suggestions. Otherwise, I look forward to seeing you in class and hope to meet you at the live session. With that, let's get to work.